Then he saw the Minotaur. Minotaur was a terrible sight to behold. The body of a tall and muscular man with the head of a raging red-eyed bull atop its broad shoulders. However, whilst it seemed ferociously strong, Theseus noticed that it also had hooves, which caused it to move in a twisted and awkward manner. Sensed the anguish that consumed the Minotaur. Trapped in the darkness, away from any company, here was a demented creature that could never fit into the world of man or beast. Prince felt pity for the creature now, upon seeing it with his own eyes, but he knew that he should still go through with what he had set out to do. Ending the Minotaur's suffering would be a kindness. The light of Theseus's torch had given the Minotaur warning of his approach. For a moment they watched each other warily, the monster pacing back and forth at the far end of the cavern. Theseus silently prepared himself, placing his torch in a wall bracket and subtly loosening his sword from its scabbard. There was no more time to waste. Theseus drew his sword. He moved towards the creature. Bellowing in rage, the Minotaur lowered its horns and charged. Just as the Minotaur was about to impale him, Theseus jumped nimbly aside. The monster went crashing into the stone wall behind him, breaking off the tip of one of its massive horns. This infuriated it further, and Theseus felt the full force of his enemy's rage up close. They circled one another, battling face to face in a deathly dance. Minotaur was much bigger and stronger than Theseus, The prince had to work hard to avoid its thrashing horns and hooves, but fortunately, the Minotaur's blind fury caused it to be careless at times, providing Theseus with several opportunities to slip in a slice here, a slash there. Time the dance continued. Even though Theseus was able to occasionally wound his opponent, the damage was too small to have any critical effect on the monster. The Minotaur was simply too strong, and Theseus was beginning to tire. Finally, the Minotaur's sharp, unbroken horn rent a mighty gash in Theseus' sword arm. While the prince reeled in pain, the monster threw him to the ground. Thinking that his opponent was defeated, the Minotaur raised its head and bellowed triumphantly. Theseus was not yet so broken that he could not seize this opportunity. As the Minotaur bellowed its apparent victory, the prince raised his sword once more and slashed with all his strength across the Minotaur's throat, cutting its head clean off. The Minotaur was dead. As he calmly bound up his wounded arm with strips torn from his own clothing, Theseus smiled proudly in the knowledge that his people would no longer have to fear the Minotaur. Wiped the blood off his sword, sheathed it, then took his flaming torch from the wall bracket where he'd left it. He then picked up the Minotaur's head so that he could prove his victory to all. Then, following the string, he began the long journey back to the surface, where Ariadne was waiting for him. When Theseus emerged from the labyrinth again, Ariadne embraced him with joy and relief. Then as the sky began to grow light, they released the prisoners and made their way down to the harbor. 15 boarded the ship that sailed back to Athens.